Hello! Copper products are the most popular barrier or non-killing method of slug control on Amazon in the UK. But does it really work? This is experiment number two, which will determine if slugs and snails can breach the defences of this copper fortress I built and eat the plants within. Defending it, there's copper mesh, copper pipe, copper tape, and copper anti-tank defences. You'll get to see firsthand more than 99% of what other gardeners have seen about copper's effect on slugs, thanks to this short video featuring 5 days worth of time-lapse footage and 2 separate experiments. The first experiment tests if slugs can cross copper to reach your plants. The second experiment examines if copper has any repellent effect at all. There's no such thing as a totally fail-proof slug barrier, so even if they cross the copper defences in the second experiment, it doesn't mean copper is useless in your quest for better pest management. If you've seen my tests of other common slug barriers, this setup will be familiar. I'll place a load of slugs on a slug stand and fill it with water, making it difficult for them to cross. The slugs only have 2 options, escape via a copper pipe or a chrome-plated pipe. Though the slug stand is usually meant to stop slugs from getting onto your potted plants, it effectively forces them to choose between the copper and chrome. If you find the content in this video useful, there's plenty more coming on this channel, so please support me by subscribing, liking, and watching. Now let's get on with the experiment. Experiment number one is nice and simple. How many slugs leave the slug stand via copper versus chrome? As a skeptic, I wasn't hopeful that copper would have a repellent effect over another metal, and thought maybe people thought it had a repellent effect, as slugs don't like the cold metallic feeling as it feels foreign to them, and that they would leave the slug stand at a fairly even split. So would I be left with egg on my face? I'll speed things up and edit out the periods of inactivity so we can get to the results quickly. So, I thought the results were quite conclusive from experiment 1. It looks highly likely that copper has a repellent effect on slugs and snails, and if you re-watch that footage closely, and you can slow down the video in the YouTube settings if you wish, you'll see slugs often recoiled when touching the copper, which didn't seem to happen with the chrome-plated pipe. Now that we're on to the final experiment, the anti-tank defences initially do quite a good job, before a not-so-elegant slug comes crashing over the copper mesh, breaching the first line of defence. And at this point I realise using a huge dahlia for the video wasn't a good idea. And whilst I show you some of the highlights from the experiment, I'll replace it with a lettuce so that we can see better.